So I got my 23andMe results in, and this happened.
Because of my.
Wait a minute. Hi, everyone. So I am here with my mama right here. Today is a special day, special video, because I, bless you, because I just got my 23andMe results. Actually, I got it in, what, yesterday. So there you go again, doing something in the back. I should have picked up your water, too. Can you tell people a little bit about your genetic background, I guess, or what you think it is?
Well, I don't know too much about my background because my parents and my grandparents didn't relay that much information to us. All I could say is that my mother was black, my father was white. But my mother is the one that raised me, and that's about it.
And my mother is obviously of mixed race, and my father, as I perceive in pictures, is a black male. He is dark skinned in the pictures, but apparently my mother told me, and when they first met, he was like her skin complexion, which I don't know. Also, she was like a very pale, when I say like pale, like kind of, you said that you're...
But that's until because I moved to Texas.
Yeah, I was getting to that. I was getting to that. She was, I guess she looked pretty white, because whenever she sees my niece, because my niece, she's also mixed too. What's Lexi mixed with?
White too.
Black and white. And she just looks like a straight up white child. She was that, but then she moved to Texas and got a lot darker because everybody knows.
But Lexi's as well has changed color too as well.
Well, yeah, because in Louisiana,
yes,
it's hot too.
Yeah, she's in Louisiana. And because of the heat difference, our skin color changed.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. She is from Louisiana. I am from Houston, Texas. My father is also from Houston, Texas. So, yeah, so.
But your father was your father's originally from Louisiana. He moved to Houston, Texas.
Oh, okay.
So he's a Louisiana too.
Okay, well, that. I wanted to do this because I was just confused on what was going on. Because you say that I'm what, like, obviously black, part white, and you said something about French and Indian,
yes,
or Native American.
Yes, we French and Indian and stuff.
Native
like,
American.
Yeah. Yes.
Just say it right. Native American.
Native American.
There you go.
And my days was Indian.
I know, okay. But it's Native American.
Okay.
Originally, this video was supposed to be with my best friend, but she has like a ton of family members at her house, and I'm not doing all that. I believe, because all African Americans, they're like 70 to 80% of sub-Saharan African. Mm-hmm. So, how much do you think I am?
I don't know. I don't even hardly know mine, so it's like, I'm gonna say about you.
I feel like I am probably 70% sub-Saharan African.
Okay.
We'll see. I just did the ancestry reports. I didn't do the health one, because I got this on sale for $80, and the other one was gonna be like almost $200. Do that, because the health one is actually cool, because it tells you like the diseases and stuff that your family could carry and what you could potentially get, and then also it could tell you like taste, but it tells you a lot of cool health stuff, but I'm not doing it. I am 73.6 sub-Saharan African. Mm-hmm. See, 67.8% is West African. 3.5% is Central and South African, and then the other 2% is broadly sub-Saharan African.
Mm-hmm.
Wonder. So there's West African, there is Central, and then there's broadly. Okay, cool. And then almost the other 25% is European. I am 14.8% Northwestern European, so it's a mix of British, Scottish, Scandinavian, French, German, and broadly Northwestern European.
Well, I know for on my behalf because of my.
Wait a minute. Wait.
Because of
Hold on a second. Okay. So this is not a big percent, but 0.7% is Jewish.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like slightly Jewish.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting. Okay, what were you about to say?
I was gonna say I knew about the French and the German part because on my family behalf of my maiden name, I knew we were part German. I knew that.
Gober?
Yes. That's a German name. And I also knew that, but because where our family come from, the South, that's the French area. So that part didn't surprise me.
No, yeah, it's kind of the French part. Because of Louisiana, and then Louisiana purchased by the French, and it makes sense. Oh, I have a tiny bit of Jewish in me. Interesting. All right, what else is there? There is East Asian and Native American. So I am 1.1% like East Asian Native American, which is basically like most of North America, South America, and obviously East Asia. So I am 0.4% Native American, also 0.4% Southeast Asian, which I don't know, located in south of China, Southeast Asia, extends to Bermuda, and Indonesia. Huh, interesting. And then the rest of the 0.3%, they don't know. So, okay. And then I have 0.3% that is unassigned, so they don't know what that is.
So you need to print it so we can save that. Put it in the safe.
Print it? Why do I need to print it? I have an account on here. I don't need to print it.
So we can have backup, just in case anything happens. We have backup documents. Even though we have computers, paperwork is very important.
The paperwork could get lost in a fire.
So
my account will get lost in a fire.
Point is that we have it as records so any other family member could see it. We can't get into your account. You should put it on a disk.
What? Who uses disk anymore, honey?
I do.
Who else besides you uses disk?
Hey, you'd be surprised.
So yeah. So that's my stuff. I would definitely like to know hers, since she is more ambiguous than I am. But I mean, this is as far as we got it so far. Would you do one? Fancy's dad did one. But would you do one? It'd be cool. All
right. One day. Yes. One day.
Wasn't there another thing that tells me how much Neanderthal I am? Ah, right here. Neanderthal. Oh yeah, there's all of these. I didn't really care for the rest, but you know what? Let's just look at it. I have 59 Neanderthal variants. This is less than 99% of... Okay.
It tells you how much you could, your ancestors could be traced back as far back as possible. Which is pretty good. 59%?
That's less than 99% of 23andMe customers. What does that mean? You are first place out of your fam... Oh. What? You are first place out of your family and friends. Oh, for what?
Well, you're probably the first one that started researching it.
Yeah, and probably.
If I would have turned around and been able to read the documents more, she would have probably had more information because she don't like to read too much documents.
I only cared about the one thing of what I was. So, if people ask me, I'm 25% white. And like 73% black. Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
Right.
I guess.
Right. Ditto.
Does that mean I can still say I'm mixed?
Yes.
Okay, I guess. But technically everyone is mixed.
Yes.
That's the thing.
Yes. Because as you go on down from generation to generation, not only from our line, you see this is why you got Jewish blood, because our ancestors started from way back then as well. See, so even though we don't, you know, come from there, every race comes from even way back then. It starts from the very beginning. But then we just drift on and we just tend to stay with our own group. And then we mix. But some people think that because your skin color is one color, that's who you are. But you're not made of your skin color. You're made of who you are on the inside.
Yeah.
That's how you're supposed to know who you are, from the inside, not the outside. Because as I stated, I was mostly pale. But then you'd be out there in the elements, and the elements change your skin color.
Also, didn't you say your hair was naturally red?
Yes.
She had naturally red hair. Oh, also, this gray, this isn't because she's aging, but she was born with this.
Yes.
With the gray, which is really cool.
Well, I was born with a strip going all the way back here.
Oh, I thought you were born with just...
No, uh-uh. I was born with it's going here, but as I got older, see, like started getting teenager, then I started having it going around here, which my mother turned around and called it. I was born with wisdom, that's why I had it down here, but then as it started going around, it's called a halo. It means that you are protected because God is with you. You know, so as I grew it up and I became more wiser, then my hair grew. Now I got more gray hair now, not because my children give me any trouble, because I've been blessed with good children. But it's a lot of wisdom that I had to learn through in life. And these wisdom was, you know, mostly godly wisdom. And as you get wiser in that area, you pretend to get more gray hair. Most people think it's because of certain things that we lose in our body and stuff like that, but it's not just that. Because knowledge will gain you a lot of things in life. Knowledge is a great experience, so don't let people fool you thinking because you got gray hair thinking that you're old. You're not old. It's that you're just more wiser than ever. You know more about life than most people. So, but I've been blessed to be born with a, say about 2 inch going all the way straight down. And when I was young, you know, I had, you know, pretty long hair as kids, and then it used to go all the way down there. But then after that, as I started getting into my teen years, it started going around and stuff, and a lot of people thought I was older than I'm supposed to be, but I'm not.
That's just so, like that baby, because there's a baby that was not going around Facebook, but her mom took a picture of the baby. Someone took a picture of the baby, and she had like a gray strip on her hair. Mm-hmm. And then her mom had the same thing too, and then they got like kind of famous mm-hmm. for it. But yeah, so she got that. Unfortunately, I didn't get it, because that would have been kind of cool.
Yes, it would have, but it's an experience that you go through. So
you were born with the strip. I didn't get the strip.
Yeah, I was born with the strip, but there is some things in life that I could say that I could say I know about, but you could say never did it, but I know about it. But that's how it is. Wisdom just comes to you, and it just happens. So. And honestly, out of all the family members that I have and stuff like that, I am the only one that had this.
See?
I'm the only one.
Also, my sisters don't have it.
Mm-hmm.
So, the only one.
And then I have many cousins. I have had many aunts and stuff like that, and I'm the only one that has it. But I've experienced a lot of spiritual things though, that as a child mm-hmm. coming up. The one good thing I like about this
23andMe.
Yeah, this 23andMe and many other results they got out there. A lot of parents are not speaking about the family anymore. And with me being one of them, I have a large family, but my parents didn't speak of a lot of things. And coming from an African-American family, a lot of them don't like to speak of it because of slavery or, you know, the things that between black and white that went through and stuff like that. Because I'm from a mixed family, my mother tried to raise me that everybody is the same. So that's why it's a little bit hard for me to see the difference between black and white. But there was a lot of things that I wish my mother would have told me. A lot of things I wish my grandmother or grandfather, when he was alive, would have told me. But then I tend to understand as I grew up and learned a lot of things would happen with black people. I understood why, but in another way, it's not good because I don't have that much to pass on to my children. Yes, this DNA is real good, but then it still doesn't replace the experience that we could give to our children. So I wish a lot of people out there would sit down and talk with their kids and share their family life. Because that is very important, because a lot of things in history is being deleted out where our kids are not learning it in the school. And when they have to research it themselves, they find out a lot of things they don't like, you know. And a lot of things that is embarrassing and shameful. You should never be ashamed of your history. Because of that history, this is why we are where we at today. This is why we have the type of freedom, the type of friendship. We could mix together, we could talk together. So even though the history was bad back then, it is still good now. You know, so I'm really glad to have this out there for my daughter to know what she could know so far. You know, I'm just sorry that I don't have a lot of the information to give her, but I am grateful that there is a lot of information out there that they could research on. So I'm grateful for that.
Speaking of the whole big family part, I guess I could say my family's kind of big too, I guess, because I have like brothers and sisters, but I don't talk to them. I don't really know anything about them. Mostly because we moved around when I was younger. That's really it. And then once again, kind of black people really don't talk to each other. I guess we just didn't have the typical black experience where it's like we're always together and like, you know, hanging out and all that stuff. I don't know. I didn't. So it's like, I really don't. I don't ask my sisters about anything. I don't ask my brothers. I don't know two of my brothers. And I don't know one of my sisters, I think. But yeah. So this was close enough.
Yeah. But with information out like this, it'll pass on to the next generation. So eventually it's going to catch up where someone in the family line will be able to gather up the information and put it together from one of our generation. So it's not like it's a downfall, it's just a stop. But now the stop is starting to go forward where it's starting to move on because new generation are researching their bloodline, and that's really good. Yes, we travel a lot, and because of that, we are not able to keep in touch too much with family members and things that is going on. Yes, of texting and Facebook, all that is good, but it's not the same thing, like I said, being there face to face, you know. And when we are face to face, everybody's so busy nowadays, nobody has time to sit down and share. You know, so most everybody now is using electronics to share, but that's still not the same thing as being there face to face and feeling the experience, you know. So, but life is what it is, and that's how things goes.
Yeah,
you know. But I'm gonna tell you one thing, I love my baby, you know. So I look now, she wanna love me too much. Okay. Okay, that's enough love, you know, but the things parents has to do for their children, I just want to say, kids, appreciate your parents. Some of them may have good parents and some of them may have bad parents, but if you have your parents in your life, appreciate them, because tomorrow is not promised. And you have to learn from their experience how to be better or how to be just like them, but never to be less, because everything your parents has to offer you, good or bad, it's worth going forward with, you know. So I'm just grateful that I have a life that I could at least show my daughter parts of this world, and she could communicate with many different people, not just with her own type of people. And because we travel a lot, as a young child she was able to communicate with many different races, and with being at many different schools, she gets to be with many different people her age, with different cultures, different backgrounds. And I like that she is not just stuck on her own kind, but that she enjoys everybody, you know, and her friends are a variety of friends, and I like that, you know. I really like that. So
maybe that's why I like the smell of matzo ball soup.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because, you know, in Maryland, there was like a lot of Jewish kids, and mm-hmm. that's all they brought to school. Mm-hmm. I love the smell of it.
Yeah. But, and because we could go to many different states, and it's much easier when you go to school, or when you was going to school, that it was much easier for you to communicate with them, you know. Because back at the time when I was going to school, you know, I didn't care to want to communicate with people, even my own kind, because when you sit and you observe and see things that is going on and you know that's not right, you tend to push yourself back. But sometimes it's good to be back, because you get to observe things. Because it is better to learn by watching than learn by doing. Because sometimes when you do some things, you make mistakes, and some mistakes you can't correct. You know, so, but when you could observe it, and you could see that mistake, I know this might happen to me if you make a mistake, and then you'll be able to tell yourself, okay, I know what to do. Why? Because I sat there, and I watched other people. And when I seen other people do it, I said, you know, well, if you would have did this, you would have did that, this wouldn't have happened. Yes, this would have happened, but it wouldn't go as far, you know. So observing is a good thing to do in life, really good. You don't have to be like other people, be yourself. And if other people don't like it, then hey, that's their choice. And that's one thing about life we have, is choices. And that's very important, you know, so. Well, I don't know what else I could tell you, but this is the experience. Because my child knows I don't like to do pictures in camera, but the things I do for my child, you know. That's why I say a true parent that love their child will do anything. Oh, I will not kill for and I will not steal. I can tell you that much. But this right here, yeah. That's an experience for me.
But she'll bail me out of jail if I do it.
Oh, I don't know about that. Well, if I punch somebody in the face and then it gets sent to jail, will you bail me?
I don't know about that neither. Okay, what if it is like they were being mean or they said...
Here is the point.
What if I'm just truly defending myself and then I get sent to jail?
Now, you're defending yourself, you shouldn't be in jail.
Well, if I was defending myself as in they start coming at me, then I have to fight back. No, I can't just stand there.
That's just the point. If they're coming at you... As defending yourself, you are not the one that's going to get charged. They will.
Well, you know how people are nowadays. Yeah. You don't know what's going to happen.
Yeah, but, yeah. You know, because sometimes you're not helping your child when you turn around and sometimes protecting them. You know, sometimes you have to let them go through that experience so that they would never do it again. Because there's a lot of children that does wrong because their parents has been there to bail them out. Instead of leaving them go through the experience and letting them handle it, and then turn around when they get out of that situation, they know to say, this is not worth it. But when you always have your parents to lean on and you grown up, that's not a good thing. It's not a good thing, you know. But if you not at fault, yes, I would bail you out. But if you was at fault, no, I would leave you there until you have to learn something.
Okay.
I would probably be sitting home crying, pulling my hair out or stuff. But I turn around and say, because I love you, I have to let you go through it.
Okay. You know, so. All right, so that's the end of this video. If you like it, please like it. Also, comment down below if you ever think about doing this or if you've done it and I don't know, whatever. Please subscribe because we're trying to get this channel to 500 subscribers by the end of the year. And that would be awesome if we could make that happen. So, bye. Like, all the way back. There you go. Okay.
Does it? Sarah.